it's a lot easier for me to tell the story of others. There's been so many experiences that I've heard that I'm just like, oh my gosh. But I have a story too, and as uncomfortable as it is, I need to tell it. Because it's important to be heard, and it's important to expose what's happened, because it was unjust. And I'm hoping that my story might add to those that have already shared, and maybe we can create some kind of change. I started in MMTLP as a torchlight holder. I purchased a torchlight. It's been 2 years. 2 years. And then they merged with MetaMaterials. And through that process, because Torchlight was a gas and oil company, the assets were set aside, and I, you know, that's how I acquired them. I did not purchase them, but I helped through the merger. And I started at that point when I entered in the Torchlight play. I'm a social worker by training. I was actually my husband's active duty Air Force, and I was a trauma counselor with the VA, and I did mostly combat trauma and counseling and military sexual trauma counseling. And I had lupus, and I got really sick, and my husband was about to deploy, and so I left my position, and we had our youngest, and so I became a stay-at-home mom. But it was something where I was so sick, and I wanted to stay home with my daughter, but I wanted to also, in some capacity, be a provider, to provide something. Even though I know that being a stay-at-home mom is, an awesome task, and it's, important, it was important to me to feel like I was helping. Particularly when I was so sick, because, I felt like my autonomy was being taken from me anyways, and I felt useless, and like I just wasn't offering anything. And so I went to try the market, something that I could stay home and be a mom, I thought maybe this is the opportunity for me. I got really sick. A few things happened. We moved for the military 3 times in 3 years. So, we were in the DC area, we moved to Florida. That's when I purchased, Torchlight. And we moved right as they were merging to MetaMaterials. And, at that point in time, that's when I got really, really sick. So sick that I couldn't lift myself up out of bed. I couldn't take myself to the restroom. We didn't find out till later, but I couldn't figure out, and my doctors couldn't either, why my neutrophils, my white blood cell count was so low, so critically low. I'd find that out when we moved to Idaho for a year, and I saw a hematologist there, because the other one couldn't figure it out. I even had a bone marrow biopsy, which is very painful. That was very painful. So I went to this new hematologist, and he told me that I have this anti-neutrophil antigen, and it's part of my lupus. And I have pericarditis, which was extraordinarily painful and was getting me back and forth from the emergency room. Lots of steroids, lots of pain, lots of exhaustion, and just feeling awful. And, we end up moving back to a different part of Florida, and my doctors are telling me, they're saying, I have breast implants, and I've had them for about 11 years, which never should have gotten them. I didn't, I would say young and dumb, but, I had lupus before I got them, and it was indicated that you're not supposed to, but I didn't know. I disclosed my illness to my doctor. And now the FDA is coming out, and they're saying that silicone breast implants, this new silicone that was supposed to be safe, is actually creating, it's giving women autoimmune diseases, specifically lupus. Yeah, so I have this autoimmune disease, this anti-neutrophil antigen, and my doctors are like, you're gonna die, essentially. Like, your body is just destroying itself. You know, I'm at the point where my neutrophil counts are so low that my own personal bacteria, everybody has bacteria in the body, but what's just normally there could be harmful to me. And they said, you know, you have to get these implants out. The FDA has recognized that these implants are making women so sick that they're causing these autoimmune diseases. But not just that, when you have implants put in your body, like mine are under the muscle, I mean, it actually deforms the bones, your rib cage. And then the other thing too is you create a capsule. Your body is like, this is foreign. So it creates a capsule that goes around the implant, and they're finding that there's a specific breast cancer that's associated specifically and only with these implants. And so I have to get them out. And it's very expensive, you know, and insurance doesn't cover it. It's like over 10 grand because you don't just have to get the implant out. You have to get this capsule out. And it's a very intrusive, invasive surgery. And I finally, you know, saw that I had enough money in my account to get this done. And so in November, I went. And even though it's scary, I went and I spoke to a reconstructive surgeon who usually works on oncology patients, but he was very familiar with the need. And he was capable. And so I went to the consultation in November and I just, you know, needed the money. And so I was like, okay, we can schedule this, you know, when I sell my MMTLP, because I was going to sell some of it and then I was going to put some into NextBridge. But I wanted to wait until the corporate actions went out and the shorts were forced to cover, because, you know, they had been shorting Torchlight for so long. There were so many synthetic counterfeit shares that were dumped into this. And finally, we felt like accountability. When I say we, I mean the MMTLP holders, the MetaFam community, that accountability would finally come. And so I wasn't going to sell until they were first forced to close their positions, because I knew that that's when it would be most beneficial for myself and my family. And I wanted, I wanted the money for my surgery so that I could finally get healthy. I wanted to be able to help my daughter with college, because she's graduating in a few months and we're trying to figure out how we're gonna pay for it. I am just devastated. I'm devastated for me, I'm devastated for others, but I'm devastated because I'm learning that the system is rigged. I'm devastated because I've been going to the FBI. Because we're Air Force, I went to the Office of Special Investigations, OSI. I went to the JAG. I went to my local politicians. I've been trying to contact the other, not my state, but the federal politicians. I've been contacting media. I went to CNN, like, to their location in person. I went to Occupy SEC in front of the SEC building. I just want to feel heard, and I'm grateful for this opportunity to be heard. But I want to be heard, and I want something to be done. I want to be made whole, and I want the suffering that not just myself and my family have experienced, but I want the suffering of all the other MMTLP holders to be not in vain, and I want to create change, and I want to be made whole with them. So I don't know if there's a call to action. This is just my story. It's been very vulnerable, and you know, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do, but I appreciate this time, and I just hope something happens. Just don't know. I just don't have much faith anymore. But we're gonna keep being loud. There's a lot of people who are doing a lot of good work, and we're gonna continue, and we're not gonna stop, because what happened to us, it's just not okay.